We have next lecture on the model millionaire. This lecture will be given by Dr. Rajesh Gore sir. He is head department of English, Toshniwal Arts Commerce Science College, Sengaon. He is MPhil NET and SET. His MPhil topic is the description of socio-political scenario in fictional works of Rowington Mystery. 15 research papers have been published by international and national journals, and 10 papers have been research papers have been presented in conferences and seminars. He has edited a book entitled Insights: Emerging Trends in English Language and Literature. So I would like to request Dr. Rajesh Gore sir to present his lecture on The Model Millionaire by Oscar Wilde.
Now, my dear students, now here I come up before you with the topic of short story, The Model Millionaire. Now here you can see the picture of that model millionaire, and on other side there is a picture of Oscar Wilde. So let's begin a short story. What is a short story? Before proceeding to the short story, it is very important for the learners of English to understand exactly what is a short story. Short story is a work of fiction, but miniature in a form. Short story is like a fiction or a full-length fiction, but it is written in a miniature or less in form. It is often written in a prose using narration. Now here is one definition given by Edgar Allan Poe to define short story as a skillful literary artist has constructed a tale. A person having a literary taste, he can create a classical short story. Now the short story has following major elements or constituents. So these are the very important elements for understanding and comprehension of short story. So let's see one by one. Number one, plot. So students must understand what is the plot. Plot is a storyline or a sequence of events presented in a short story. Then characters. What is characters? Characters are a person or human beings presented in a short story. So characters are in less in number in a short story as compared to fiction. Then setting. What is setting of short story? The setting of short story is indicate a time period, timeline, or a particular geographical location. When you read any kind of short story, where you can find a timeline period or the geographical location or the names of cities, countries, and towns indicated by the particular writer in their stories. Then dialogue. What is dialogue? Dialogue is a communication between two persons or more than two persons. So dialogue is very important. Without dialogue, the story cannot be live. And narration. What is narration? Narration is very important for the short story. Narrator narrates a short story with expressing his own point of view. So there are three types of narration: first person narration, second person narration, and third person narration. First person narration indicates with the first person I. When you find in any short story I, that is the first person narrative. When you find the second plural person like you and they, it is called second person narrative. And when you can find the third person narrative, when there is he, she, it, or the name of particular person like Rajesh is there. So these are the third person narrations. So these narrations are very important form to express the point of view of the short story writer. Then language. So what is the language of the short story? The language of the short story is very precise, compact, and it is economically used by the short story writer considering the particular specific audience. And then there is a compositions. Short story writer use the particular diction, words, or sentences to give the meaningful work into the any work of art. Without meaningful words and sentences, the any work of art cannot be a meaningful or fruitful. So these are some of the major elements of the short story. It is very essential for the learners of English to make aware with these elements. Then now here, the biographical sketch of Oscar Wilde. Oscar Wilde was born on 16th October 1854 in Dublin. He was died on 13th November 1900 in Paris. And he was an Anglo-Irish poet, novelist, poet, and critic. He wrote in different forms or genres of literature in 1880s. So now he has written in various types of genres like play, novel, poem, and critical works. So it is very important for the students from the examination point of view. You can get here MCQs. And in 1890s, he became the most popular writer in London. And he was honored with the Newdigate Prize in 1878. So here I would like to mention that this Newdigate Prize is very important. It is equal to Nobel Prize. Then, major works of Oscar Wilde. What are the major works of Oscar Wilde? The Complete Short Stories, a famous collection of short stories. The Happy Prince and Other Tales, 1888, a collection of fairy tales. So from this collection, we have one short story, The Happy Prince, in our second year syllabus. Then The Picture of Dorian Gray, 1891, his first and only novel. And here are some of the major plays of Oscar Wilde. A Lady Windermere's Fan, 1892. Women of No Importance, 1893. An Ideal Husband, of 1895. The Importance of Being Earnest, 1895. So these are the significant contribution given by Oscar Wilde in literature. So it is also useful for the students from the examination point of view. So you should watch it again and again. So it will be helpful for you. Then next, major characters in short story. So when you read any kind of short story, it is very important or significant to understand the characters of that story. So here I have given a characters: Huey Erskine, protagonist of the story; Laura Martin, the beloved of Huey Erskine, or daughter of the retired Colonel Martin. Colonel Martin was the father of Laura Martin; Allen Tarver, painter, artist, and friend of Huey Erskine; Baron Hausberg, the rich man or millionaire in Europe; Gusto Nodin, the old gentleman and servant. So these are the significant characters in a short story. So these characters are minimum in numbers as compared to fiction or full-length fiction. So student must concentrate on these characters. If you understand the significance of characters or characters, you can automatically understand the story. Then, now about short story. The Model Millionaire. So what is exactly the Model Millionaire is? The Model Millionaire is first appeared in newspaper The World in June 1887. It again republished in 1891. The story has a proper beginning, middle, and end. So when you start to read the story, you can find a sentence or statement in the beginning line. Unless one is wealthy, there is no use of being a charming fellow. This is the opening line. Here you can find the beginning. And then middle, in the middle part of the story, you can find the condition put forth by the Laura Martin's father, Colonel Martin, before Huey Erskine. And in the end, you can find there is the twist in ending. So there is the check of £10,000 received from Baron Hausberg to Huey Erskine. So this is the plot line. And then a story of young man's struggle. So now here, you can see a story of young man's struggle, Huey Erskine. Huey Erskine is the protagonist of the story. He was unemployed, who has not wealth, money. He was fallen in love with Laura Martin, but he cannot able to marry with her because of his financial condition. And so he was struggling to get his love. And then he's longing for love. He was, there is a love episode between Laura Martin and Huey Erskine. He was in persuasion of love of Laura Martin. And due to of his financial or economical condition, he is not able to get her love. And his preservation of value systems. Now here is a very important, even though he was economically or financially struggling, but he never crossed the lines of values or morality to lead in his critical or crisis in the life. His behavioral act of kindness. In this story, we come across the act of kindness. So when we read the story, and there is the act in the studio of Allen Tarver, when Alan Tower was giving the final touches of his portrait of old beggar man, and by seeing the worst or piteous condition of that old beggar man, the Huey Erskine expressed his kindness towards that particular fellow or beggar man, and he offered him a sovereign in his hand. This act shows the kindness of Huey Erskine. The element of surprise. And in the Pallet Club of London, there is a visit of Alan Tower and Huey Erskine, where he come to know that beggar man, earlier he has seen in the studio of Alan Tower, he was not a beggar man, but he was the richest man in Europe. So this was the element of surprise for the Huey Erskine. Then his act of kindness brings a life-changing response in his life. So it is very important when we say the plot in twist, whatever act he has earlier done by giving a sovereign to that old beggar man, and ultimately he has rewarded for that, and he got the check of 10,000 pounds from Baron Hausberg. So it changes the life of Huey Erskine and Laura Martin. So this is the outline of the short story. It will be helpful for the students to understand. Now then, we will see analysis of the story, The Model Millionaire. The Model Millionaire is structured in three major scenes. So now here I have given three major scenes for the understanding of the students. How does it take place? The first scene takes place at a painter's studio. So now here you can see the picture of that painter's studio, where you can see three characters. Huey Erskine, Alan Tower is painting the picture of that old beggar man who is seated in the corner of the studio. So now in this studio, the first scene takes place. The second scene takes place at the Pallet Club. So there is a picture of the Pallet Club in London, where the Alan Tower and Huey Erskine met. And first time here, the Huey Erskine come to realize that the old beggar man was not a beggar man, but he was the richest man in Europe. Then third scene takes place at Huey's home. So there is a home of Huey in London. And you can see that picture on my slide. So in this last scene or third scene, we can see there is the arrival of the servant from Alan Tower's office, who offered him a 10,000 pounds check as a wedding gift. So these are the three crucial scenes in the story. So it will also helpful for the students. Then let's move the narration. Narration is very important. The third person narration which determines the point of view of protagonist. So in this story, the narrator has used third person narration. First of all, it determines the point of view of protagonist. So now here is a sentence. He looked so forlorn, wretched, that Huey could not help pitying him and felt in pockets to see what money he had. So when he see the pitying condition of that beggar man, he utter the said sentences. And this sentence is expressed in a third person narration that directly appeals to the reader or the audience. And then not only the protagonist point of view is important, but here you can see the narrator seems to be omniscient in narration by expressing his own point of view. So this is the significant for understanding of narration. Then setting and time of story. The story is set in Victorian England, most likely London. So it is a setting, just I have said earlier told setting. The short story is setting in a particular geographical location. So the story is set in Victorian England and most likely London. But in this story, we cannot come across the exact time and name of the city when we read the short story, The Model Millionaire. Holland Park and Pallet Club in London is mentioned in story. When you go through the story, you can find two names are there. Holland Park, where is the name of, where is the residence of that Laura Martins? And Pallet Club, where the Alan Tower and Huey Erskine met in London. These two names are only mentioned in the story. And the story reads to be a contemporary one. It looks like, it seems to be contemporary one, because in this story, we can see the issues of love. The youth is tempting in a love, falling in a beautiful girl in persuasion or in getting her. Then secondly, we can see there is an issue of unemployment. Still, the youth of the country is struggling due to the unemployment. The government has given a false promises to the youth. In coming days, we will generate a number of employments, but they are not actually done. And they are still struggling due to that unemployment into depression. And then here we can also find there is a surprising element suddenly happening in the life of that youth. And he was delighted at last. The story, then the main action of the story takes place over 2 days. When you read the story, the action of the story takes place over 2 days. So this is the setting and timeline of the story. Then composition of story. The story is written in a mixed narrative using direct narration and short responses. So here I have given an example of direct narration. My dear boy, said Trevor. It is a direct narration used by Oscar Wilde in the story. Then compositional elements added to story. So now here a foreshadowing, number one. Foreshadowing, it interprets the backstory of Erskine. When in the short story, you come across with the father of Huey Erskine, who is actually passed away. But he kept nothing in heritage for Huey Erskine. He left behind him only some books and cavalry sword that was not useful or actually in use for Huey Erskine. Then in the story, we come across the twist in a plot. So when you see or when you read the story, earlier he had done the act of kindness or showing the pity towards that old beggar man. He offered him a sovereign, and in the final part of the story, he received for that act £10,000 check as a act of generosity of Baron Hausberg. So it is a twist in a plot, poetic justice. So whatever actually already he had done earlier, that was rewarded in the form of that check. So that is a poetic justice. Whatever act we have performed earlier, that was rewarded later on. Then plot of the story. When we see the plot line of the story is organized in a particular plot line or a sequence of a short story. It is a classical plot of the story that includes following elements. So exposition. So in exposition, we can found to certain kind of circumstances from which the action take place and the protagonist performing that kind of actions. Then rising action explains the progress or the growth or the development of the story. Climax, that take turn for better or worse. So in climax, we have seen there is a reward for Huey Erskine in the form of £10,000 check. Then falling action that unravels the complications. Whatever the complications arise in the love of Laura Martin and Huey Erskine, that is unraveled in the final part of the story. And resolution that decide the fate of the protagonist. And ultimately, he lead his life happily with his own beloved Laura Martin. So this is the plot line of the story. And then now here, the themes of story. So now here are some of the major themes of the short story. So number one, wealth. Now wealth is one of the significant theme of the short story. Unless one is wealthy, there is no use of being a charming fellow. So now here, Huey Erskine is the protagonist who is suffering because of financial instability or wealth. If you want to lead your day-to-day life, the money is required. Without money, you cannot lead your life happily. So he has no any kind of source to achieve or to earn money. So he was depend for his livelihood upon his old aunt who gave him £2,000 for a year. And on that £2,000, he has to fulfill his daily needs. Then there is another major themes. Unemployment. Unemployment is a very important theme in this short story. That is the burning issue in the recent scenario also. But in this short story, when we come across the hero having a good personality, good charming personality, he's very handsome, equally men and women, but he has not any kind of enough employment. So he has tried his luck in a various professions like He has tried his hand in a stock exchange market for 6 months. He started his business as a tea merchant, but that is also not run for so longer. He has sold dry sherry fruits, which is helpful in made of wine, but he got failure over there. And then there is, we can say, ultimately he became nothing. Delightful, ineffectual young man with a perfect profile, but no profession. He has a perfect profile, but having no profession. So without employment, you don't have any kind of status in the society. And he was victimized due to this unemployment and wealth. Then there is another theme, that is love. When the love is very important. So in this story, we come across the theme of love between Huey Erskine and Laura Martin. Here I have given a picture. Both are in love with each other, intimate love with each other, but they cannot engage with each other because of financial instability or because of wealth. And the father of Laura Martin also was fond of Huey Erskine, but he cannot give a permission of Huey Erskine to engage with his daughter Laura Martin because of his financial instability. And he put forth one condition. Come on, my boy, to me when you have 10,000 pounds of your own. So he raised the conditions. Whenever you have 10,000 pounds of your own, then I will be ready to marry my daughter with you. Then there is another theme, morality and beauty. So morality and beauty is as important as wealth. Wealth is not important, but morality and beauty is also important. When we come across in the story, the narrator narrates the character like Huey Erskine having morality and beauty in his behavior, even though he has not a money or wealth. So the people considering that due to his unfortunate luck, he was struggling in his day-to-day life and called him a loser, but he was compensated these things by his charming personality, morality, and beauty. Then we come across another theme, class consciousness. When we read the story, here are the various kinds of character. Just we have seen here the class stratification of Victorian England. So now here we have seen the character of beggar, old beggar man, who presents the poor or poverty. Then there is a character of Huey Erskine, Laura Martin, Colonel Martin, and Alan Tabor. They represent the middle class society. And lastly, there is a character of Baron Hausberg, who represents the upper class society. So this kind of class stratification we can see in this story. Then kindness and generosity. These are the major themes in this story. Earlier we have seen, by seeing the pitying condition of that old beggar man, Huey Erskine expressed his kindness and curiosity towards the old beggar man by offering him sovereign and some old clothes in his home, which will be by seeing the worst condition of that beggar man. And in the reverse of this kindness, he has received the generosity from that Baron Hausberg in the form of envelope. In that envelope, there was a check of 10,000 pounds. And on the envelope, there was written, it was a wedding gift for Laura Martin and Huey Erskine. And in this marriage ceremony, the Baron Hausberg given a speech, and Alan Tower said that millionaire models are rare, but the model millionaires are rarer still. So Alan Tower remarked in the last line, millionaire models are rare, but model millionaires are rarer. So this is the very significant ending of this. Thank you very much for listening me. And I have my YouTube channel, Literature Insights, where I have made up the educational videos on syllabus or curriculum. So in coming days, you will also getting the videos on MCQs on this same story. So thank you for watching me, and thank you for giving me an opportunity, Knowledge Sir, in this online lecture series. Thank you, Gute Sir. Thank you, Lakhotia Ma'am. And
thank you.
Thank you, everyone. And thank you, my dear students.
Thank you, Guru Sir. You have touched all aspects of this story. So I thank you for wonderful presentation. Now I'd like to request Lakhotia ma'am to propose vote of thanks.
Dr. Rajesh Gore, your wonderful insight on all the aspects of the work that you have taken was very useful for the students from all the angles. You have taken the themes, you have taken the setting, you have taken everything for the compulsory students also, and that will definitely give them an insight for optional part also.